I love girl.
I am Oog. I love girl. Girl loves Boog. It is bad situation. Boog and I are very different people. For example, we have different jobs. My job is rock thrower. I will explain what that is. There are many rocks all over the place, and people are always tripping on them. So, when I became a man at age 11, the old person said to me,
"Get rid of all the rocks."
Since that day, 10 years ago, I have worked very hard at this. Whenever it is light outside, I am gathering rocks and throwing them off the cliff. Boog's job is artist. I will explain what that is. When he became a man, the old person said to him,
"Cut down the trees so we have space to live."
But Boog did not want to do this, so now he smears paint inside caves. He calls his smears pictures. Everybody likes to look at them, but the person who likes to look at them most is girl. I love girl. I will explain what that is. When I look at her, I feel sick, like I'm going to die. There are many women in the world, by last count, 7. But she is the only one I ever loved. Girl lives on Black Mountain. It is called Black Mountain because, 1, it is mountain, and 2, it is covered in black rocks. Every day, girl has to climb over the rocks to get to the river. It is too hard. She has small legs, and she is often getting stuck. So one day, I decided I will clear a path from girl's cave to the river. I have been working on girl's path for many years, picking up the black rocks and carrying them away. I never throw her rocks off the cliff like normal rocks. Instead, I put them in a pile next to my cave. I like to look at the pile because it reminds me of how I am helping girl. My mother, who I live with, says the pile has to go. I worry that she will move the pile, but it is unlikely. After all, she is an elderly 32-year-old woman. I have made good progress on girl's path, but there are still many rocks left. The job would go faster, but I am clearing the path in secret by the light of the moon. The reason is, and this is a hard thing to admit, I am afraid to talk to girl, because the truth is, I am not so good at making words. Boog is very good at making words. For example, last week, he showed off his new picture at the main cave. Everyone was expecting it to be a horse or a bear. All his pictures so far have been horses, bears, or a mix of horses and bears. But this picture was not of any animal. It was just a bunch of red streaks. People were angry. It was a bad situation. I thought that Boog would lose his job or maybe be killed by stones. But then Boog stood on a rock and spoke.
"My art is clever, and anyone who does not get it is stupid."
Everyone was quiet. We looked at the old person to see what he would say. The old person squinted at the red streaks for a while. Then he rubbed his chin and said,
"Oh, yes, now I get it. It is clever. People who do not get it are stupid."
A few seconds later, everyone else got it. "It is clever," they said. "It is clever." The only person who did not get it was me. My beard began to sweat. I was scared that someone would ask me to make words about the picture. I headed slowly for the exit. I was almost out of the cave when Boog pointed his finger at me.
"Do you like it, Oog?"
Everyone stopped making words and looked at me. "It is clever," I said. I meant for my voice to sound big, but it came out small. Boog smiled.
"Ah, then why don't you explain it to us?"
I felt a burning on my skin. It was sort of like when you fall into a cooking fire and your body catches on fire. I looked at my feet and people started laughing. I looked up at girl to see if she was one of the ones laughing. She was not, thank gods, but she could hear all the other people laughing, and that was just as bad.
I am tired from talking to people who are less clever. I'm going to mate with girl now.
Boog took girl's hand and started to mate with her. Some people stayed to watch, but most took this as their cue to leave. On my way out, I heard girl making sounds. They stayed in my head all night, like an echo in an empty cave. The next day, I decided to become an artist. I told my plan to Oog. There are several of us named Oog. I'm sorry if it is confusing. And he said,
"You can't be an artist. It is hard."
Oog agreed with him.
"You're a rock thrower. Stick with that."
I was angry at Oog, partly because he always takes Oog's side, but mostly because I did not agree with his words. Maybe artist is hard job. It is not for me to say. But I would be surprised if it was as hard a job as rock thrower. Throwing rocks is not so easy. For example, 5 years ago, one of my shoulders detached from my arm when I was throwing a boulder off the cliff. And 2 years after that, the other shoulder detached also. I can still throw rocks off the cliff, but now when I throw them, I am screaming. Not just once in a while, but constantly. Every time I throw a rock, I am screaming, loud. I do not even realize I am screaming. It is just part of my life. Another thing is that sometimes I fall off the cliff, which is a bad situation. "I am going to make a picture," I told the others. "A good one."
"Who are you going to show it to? Your mother?"
Everyone laughed. Oog, Oog, Moog. Even Oog. "No," I said. "I will show it to girl." No one made words after that. I have never spoken to girl, but one time she spoke to me. It was the first day of school, and we were learning to count. It was confusing. I'm very good at some numbers. I understand 1 and 2 very well. And I am okay with 3. But when it gets to advanced maths, like 4 or 5, I have trouble. The old person had told us each to make a pile of 5 rocks. He was about to call on me when girl whispered in my ear,
"You have too many rocks. You need to take away 4.
I stared at her. I think she could tell from my eyes that I did not have a great grasp of 4.
"It's 2 twos.
I swallowed. To this day, I do not know what she meant by this.
"Don't worry, I will help you."
The old person was about to look at my pile when girl stood up and pointed into the forest and yelled,
"Predator!"
By the time we came back from the hiding cave, it was night. On the second day of school, we graduated, and I got my sheepskin just like everybody else. I wanted to thank girl, but I did not know which words to make. So I said nothing. Girl has a small head, so it is very strange how she fits so many things inside of it. She knows all the numbers, 6, 8, you name it. I do not know how she learned so much, but I have developed a theory, which is that she is a witch who knows magic. I decided to make my picture of horses because I knew that was a thing. My plan had been to show it to girl. But now that it was finished, I started to worry that she would not like it. The reviews, so far, were not great. Oog said,
"It is the worst picture made yet by a human."
One of the main problems, he explained, was that I had not given the horse any legs. Also, I had given it hands, forgetting that a horse has no hands. I decided it was best to destroy it before girl found out about it. I grabbed some empty bladders and brought up water from the river. I was about to splash the painting when I heard a familiar laugh.
"Ha-ha-ha-ha." "Don't destroy your bad picture yet. There is someone who wants to see it."
It was Boog. He grabbed girl by the arm and thrust her in front of my picture. It was a bad situation.
"Tell Oog what you think of it."
"Boog, come on."
"Tell him."
"I do not like it. You are not clever. I love Boog and not you.
I stood there in silence. Hot water came out of my eyeballs. Boog walked over to my pile of black rocks, picked one up and hurled it against my picture.
Let's go, girl.
She started to follow him. As she was leaving, she paused to take a rock from my pile. I was afraid she would throw it at my picture like Boog had. But instead, she held it up to her face and squinted at it.
Let's go.
Girl followed him into the woods, still holding the rock in her hand. My mother woke me in the night.
A monster is here to murder us.
I nodded. This is usual occurrence. What kind of monster? Wolf? She shook her head.
It is a clever monster. Listen.
The monster was throwing rocks against the cave. I took my killstick and headed outside. I saw a figure in the shadows and was about to charge it when the moon appeared suddenly between the clouds. Girl was standing on the edge of the forest, a black rock in her hand.
Sorry if I scared you. I came to say thank you.
I was confused. For what?
For clearing me a path.
How did you know it was me?
I took a rock from your pile and compared it with the ones on my mountain. They're the same kind.
I walked cautiously towards her. Are you a witch?
I'm not a witch. I just use common sense.
She put her hand on my arm and the hairs on it stood up.
Thank you for clearing all the rocks. It is a good path. You are good at clearing the rocks.
For the second time that night, hot water came out of my eyeballs.
I'm sorry I said those mean things about your picture. Boog made me.
I was shocked. That had not occurred to me. Boog had been clever. Does that mean you like my art? I asked.
It's interesting. But you know what I really like? Your rock pile. It's sort of like a sculpture.
What is sculpture?
Like a picture in three dimensions.
Much time passed in silence. Girl, may I impregnate you?
What?
I know I am not clever like Boog. I do not understand art, and I am bad with the numbers, but I will work hard to clear the rocks for you. And when you have child, I will clear the rocks for the child. I will clear all the rocks for you and the child until I am eaten by a monster or die of the great disease. I will make you many paths so you can go all the places you want. I paused to catch my breath. It was the most words I had ever made at one time.
What about Boog?
I thought about it for a moment. I will murder him, I said. She smiled and kissed me on the cheek. It was like it had been in my dreams. We made many words that night. Girl explained that she never really loved Boog. He just seemed like her only option. No one else had ever asked to mate with her. The other six men on Earth, including me, had been too afraid. The stars were out, and Girl counted them out loud until I fell asleep. The next day, I took a large rock and struck it against Boog's head so that his skull cracked open and he died. Afterwards, Girl and I went swimming. We have decided to have many children. One, two, maybe even a higher number. I love Girl. Girl loves me. It is good situation.